Tuesday afternoon. I'm Karen Greer. Another day of searching in eastern Alabama after it was determined to be an EF tornado with 170 mile per hour winds. We're learning more about the 23 victims killed in the small community of Beauregard, Alabama. One family lost at least seven people. Now, CBS 46's Daniel Wilkerson is the first Atlanta reporter allowed by law enforcement into that community where this happened. And Daniel, you're at Beauregard High School, where you've just been briefed on all the latest information.
We did, Karen. Good morning to you from Beauregard, Alabama. We just got the names of all the victims. I can tell you they range in ages from age 6 to 89. Just going down this list, it really makes everything real. Of course, it's been real all along for these families who lost their loved ones. But take a look. Today, we got an even closer look at what the survivors are up against. This is that neighborhood, and Beauregard hit hard. This morning, we went live outside the home of a state trooper badly hurt. He's in ICU right now. His family reportedly optimistic that he'll make a full recovery, but their story is one we've seen throughout this community. The paths of debris, as you can see there, well, they are incredible, from items that once belonged to children to appliances to furniture. All of the items these families had a part of their routine lives just days ago. CBS Evening News anchor Jeff Glore is here covering the devastation. I spoke with him just a little while ago. Take a listen. Jeff, you've seen a lot of these tragic scenes. What stands out about this one?
I've never seen a tornado like this. I was in Moore, Oklahoma almost 6 years ago now. The death toll right now at this point in Moore was higher, similar, but there was destruction there. But in terms of just the path of this and how wide it was and how bad some of the areas are, I haven't seen anything like that before.
We learned it at press conference just a little while ago that authorities are still looking for 7 to 8 people. They say that their efforts today will likely turn to one of recovery instead of search and rescue. Back out here live, of course, this town is coming together, and they say that they didn't know that they were this strong into this tragedy. We're live in Lee County, Alabama. Daniel Wilkerson, CBS 46 News. Wow.